Okay, hi, my name is Brandy. I'm here to give a dream about a rapture dream that I had. I actually had a few, but this is the first one, honestly, that I can think of that stands out. I'll be posting more videos about my other ones, but this is one that I want to give first because it's kind of relating to some of the videos that I've seen already, and I think that it can be a benefit to some people as like confirmation. So, in my dream, me and my family were on a bus, and there something huge happened. I don't know exactly what happened. All I know is we were on a bus, and as I look out the window, I see the world is like in despair. Like everything that I see that's outside is like broken down, beaten down, you know, as if like a bomb had happened, or as if, you know, something that destroyed the earth happened, like rattled it to where it wasn't the same. It was dark, and you know, there was a dark feeling to this dream, and it was, you know, everything was kind of messed up. People were looting, and all this was like something that would have like an apocalypse. And so me and my family were on this bus though, and we're on our way to a church. When we get to the church, this church is huge. There's, I don't know, numerous amounts of people. It's so big. And I remember sitting next to my mom, and she was excited about the word. And when I looked up at the pastor, it was like a man that was excited to give the word. And there was an elder. The church was so huge that the stage was shaped like like half of a square. Like it went around like that, you know, to cover around the corners of the building so that he was able to walk around and that everyone in the building was able to hear his word. And I remember just following him around the stage, and he was so excited and preaching the word. And I remember after the word, I was lit on fire, and I said, you know, I want to be a part of this. So I go to the restroom. And there was I believe it was an usher board or some kind of staff at the church. And I told her, how can I be a part of this? I want to be a part of this church, you know, to preach the word of God. Like, what should I do? And she said, you can be a part of this. And I said, well, what should I do? But I told her, but I have a problem with bad language, you know, with cursing. And I'm cursing, and I'm trying to get rid of that habit. And she said, specifically, you know, I can deal with that. You know, we can deal with that. You can get over that. And, she said, but you can be a part of our church. So I was excited about that. And I remember like instantly in the restroom, I had a child, and the child was like, a girl. I remember seeing that she was a girl, kind of pale, you know, small, you know, girl, I want to say like around a 6-month-old child. And, I come outside of the church. God gave me the revelation later on that this child represented my spirit, you know, and it was my spirit. And so to continue on, I ended up, my sister, my mom disappeared for some reason, and my sister, she went, I remember her going outside to go fetch the car while I was in the restroom. So while I'm talking to the young lady, and I come outside, and there's a gate surrounding the church, a metal fence. And when you look outside of the fence, the entire world is just crumbled, like horrible. Everyone's looting, scavenging for things, fighting, and there's all this despair. And I look outside the gate, and I see that there's a dog there. This dog has piercing red eyes. And I later found out, you know, with the confirmation of someone else's YouTube dream, rapture dream, that this dog was a hellhound. The same dog that she described in her dream was in my dream. That's how I know it's confirmation, and her eyes were piercing red. The dog's eyes was piercing red, and I knew that it was coming for my baby, the child that I was holding, which represented my spirit. And but in the distance, there was a guy that was spraying water. You know, water was hard to come by, so I knew that this was holy water. Water was hard to come by. He was squirting the water, like with a water hose, like a fire hose, spraying it at the dog so that the dog would like leave me alone, basically. And as I see him spraying this water, I see that there's babies on the ground that are dead, you know. And I didn't know what they were. I thought they might have been dead animals. Sorry to be so graphic, but I thought they might have been dead animals. But it turns out that these were children because I saw the diapers on them, and you know they were really small and really skinny, and I can see the spines in them. And I remember that God told me this represents the spirit, and you have to protect it. So I knew that this dog wanted my child, my spirit. So I had to protect it, and I stood there for a minute to think what I should do because I needed to protect this child. And my sister ended up driving up in her car, and I go to step out of the fence, and when I'm going to step out of the fence, the dog gets smaller and smaller, smaller until it eventually like leaves. It turns from me as it's getting wet with the hose from this man that I can't even see his face. You know, so I go and I get in the car, and my sister's not speaking to me for some reason. It's like I can't get her attention. She doesn't hear what I'm saying, and we end up stopping at this store to get, to get like goods that we needed because I guess we're going on a journey. I just had the feeling like we have to go on a journey, and we go and we stop to get these things. And when we stop at the store, there's all these people in front of it. I don't know if they had been looting. I don't know if they're waiting to steal people's things. Sorry about the dis. That I'm outside. I don't know if they're waiting to steal people's resources or what it was about, but it was a crowd of people outside. And as we pull up, I realize that it's someone that I know. And I hop out of the car and I'm like, "What are you doing here? You know, what are you doing?" And to try to witness to him. And he follows, he's not hearing what I'm saying at all. And he follows me to the car. And when he gets to the car, he tries to get in the car, but he doesn't try to get on my side. He goes on the side where I have my child. He goes on the side where my child is, which represented my spirit. And he's trying to attack, like trying to get in the car. He's beating on the window, kind of like a zombie. Kind of, it reminded me of that. And I start screaming and I go to like get him, you know, out of there. Like, "Get off. No, you need to leave. Get off," you know, and I'm kicking and I'm screaming, and eventually he falls off and he falls away. And me and my sister are driving, and I just realized we're driving off into the distance. And you know, that was just confirmation of seeing my friend, is that there are a lot of people that aren't going to be saved. And even I was filled with fear when I realized that this is post, you know, apocalyptic, and I was still left behind, even though I was part of a church, you know. And I thought of the five virgins, five are wise and five are foolish, and half of the church is foolish because the virgins represent the church. And I don't want to be left in that crowd, and I know that nobody else does, so it's just time to repent and get right with God. I felt like this dream was significant, and it was a rapture dream. And if anyone else has something to say about this dream, any, you know, points that they can add or anything that they can say to encourage me or give me confirmation about this dream or their opinion, or even if they had a dream that was similar to it, I appreciate it. Post it, reply with it. And I needed to say this dream because, you know, there's a lot of people that are dreaming out there, and I wanted to be a part of the church and put this word out. God bless you guys. All right.